Told him I was gonna be some. That broke shit made me sick. Big appetite with a weak stomach. Ain't had nowhere to go.
What's poppin', Stack Squad? How y'all doing today, man? It's DJ and Vince again. Back on the video, man, as always. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, he back. He back for good. But,
what?
You ain't back for good?
Yeah.
Okay, then. My point. I don't sound like that first off.
You sound even like a poor girl.
I will take off that.
Shut up! Shut up! How y'all doing, man? What's the topic for today, man?
You want to do random or you got something in mind? Oh, yeah, also, bro, if we get there early, can we go to McDonald's and get something real quick?
Sure.
All right. All right, word. So, did you do the interview yesterday, or are you doing it today?
I had an interview yesterday, but, you know, like I said, we talked about that in the video.
Oh, matter of fact, let's actually talk about what happened yesterday. All right, guys. So, I found a topic. We're going to talk about when you're going in for an interview, you know what I'm saying, what to do and all that good stuff, because, you know what I'm saying, he's been through a bunch of jobs. I've only been through.
I've been through three jobs, and if I get this one, it'll be four.
That's what I'm saying. You've been through more jobs than I have. This is my second job.
I know.
But still, we're going to talk
You've
about
had
the
half the jobs I've had.
That's what I'm saying. But still, we're going to talk about the
Shut up!
Shut up!
Shut up! That's going to be
gotta
some.
Do it when I do it. Just like I ain't gonna do it when you do it.
Well, still, yeah. So, Jesus. Man, shut up and like that black him out. But yeah, we're going to talk about, like, you know what I'm saying, the process, and you know what I'm saying, when you go in the interview, you know what I'm saying, how to talk and, you know, how to, all that good stuff, you know what I'm saying, to make sure that you get the job. It doesn't work?
Hey, no, it's out of fluid.
Dang. Man, if he doesn't get his morning black and mild smoking, you know what I'm saying, he's going to be mad for the rest of the day. Don't tell me that one ain't running either.
Nope.
Bro, what the freak, man? Oh my gosh, bro.
You can go on somebody. I'm crapping you.
Dang.
Hey, you got a lighter?
Dang, bro. Now you're just freshly mad. See, this is what happens when he doesn't get this morning smoking, right? He gets even more furious than what he normally is.
You're gonna make cold son of a guns this morning.
I'm good. I got it on a hoodie, so I'm good. I ain't worried about you.
Yeah, shut up.
See, look at it. You see, he's already mad. Are we going to talk to him about the process, man?
I forgot what you were saying about the process.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, going in and talking to the manager, whoever you're talking to and stuff like that. Like,
I ain't going in nowhere.
Okay, guys. Well, dang. Well, you're not being a big help at all. But, guys, when I went to go in for my first job.
Oh, you mean in general?
Yes, in general, you dummy. What do you think I meant?
Oh, I thought you were talking about for me.
No, I'm talking about in general. Like, it doesn't matter if you're doing virtual or not virtual, bro. I'm talking about for a job in general, bro. Come on now.
Okay, kids. And teenagers. And some adults.
We got to get right.
When y'all go to apply for a job, you walk in, never, ever, ever give the application to a non-manager. Don't give it to the cashier. Don't give it to the bookkeeper. Give it to the manager or the boss.
Yeah, because you have
to. Let me tell you something. I've worked in several places. When you give it to the cashier, or when you give it to the bookkeeper, they're either going to forget that you gave it to them and just throw it away, or they're just going to throw it around on the manager's desk where it could possibly just fly away. Or any other kind of case scenario.
Yeah, so make sure that when you have application.
So when you walk in the building of whatever you're applying for, always say, where is the manager? And when they say, what can I help you with? Because more than likely they will. Vincent, tell me if I'm wrong.
You're not wrong, bro.
Okay. Say, I just want to hand in my application. And they say, well, I'll take it and I'll give it to him when I see him. Be like, no, I don't like that. I want to give it to him in person.
Yeah, because when you give it to him in person, it shows, you know what I'm saying, a lot of courage. Nine times out of ten.
Yeah. 9 times out of 10. I don't have my morning smoke in, but 9 times out of 10. Manager will more than likely open it up if it needs to be opened up, or will sit there and look at it and make sure it's filled out all the way. And then he'll be like, all right, we'll give you a call in the next few days and let you know something. But if you just go to the cashier, you think the cashier is going to care, or you think the bookkeeper is going to care if you didn't answer a question or
Write down
your signature or whatever? No.
They don't even have the decency to like tell you if you see it, if they see it.
Yeah. And then the manager's going to look at that if he does or if she does. Then they're going to be like, this person here is stupid because they didn't fill this in or whatever.
Exactly, guys. So when y'all get an application to fill it out, make sure you fill out everything, because the manager's gonna look for everything that's on there. Because if you miss one thing, man, that can jeopardize the job. So make sure you fill in everything that you need to fill in for the application and stuff like that. And make sure, like he said, always ask for the manager, because you don't want to give it to no worker, because the worker isn't even really gonna care, because they're working their job. They ain't gonna care about, you know what I'm saying, your application to the manager. So. So that's
they're not going to get in trouble for an application being thrown away. There's plenty of other people out there that's actually handed their application to the manager.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
That they're actually worried about.
Exactly. Like, the workers, they ain't going to care, bro, because they're working. They ain't worried about you. You know what I'm saying? So we talked about the application process. Now we're going to talk about actually going in for an interview and, you know what I'm saying, setting it up with the manager, you know what I'm saying? So with that, you know what I'm saying, the first thing is you want to dress presentable. Doesn't mean you have to throw on like a suit or something like that. Just throw on some khakis, some dress shoes, and then a polo shirt or collar shirt, and you're good to go.
But don't overdo it.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't want to go in there with a freaking like suit looking like a mafia boss or something like that. You want to just dress nice and casual, you know what I'm saying, and then just go in there for the interview. Wait, no, it's right there. No, it's over there. Huh? What time is it, bro? Make sure we got some good bedtime. Probably
don't know, dude. Man,
I don't know, dude.
6:19.
All right, where we good? But yeah, make sure, you know what I'm saying, just casual. You don't have to OD it, bro, unless you like you have like one of them high paying jobs. But other than that, just dress nice and casual.
Don't go wearing a suit to a job that requires you to clean bathrooms.
Especially that, bro. If you ain't freaking a lawyer or like you got one of them type of jobs, don't throw on a suit, man, because you ain't gonna need it.
Don't dress up in general. I mean, dress appropriate.
Yeah,
but
like,
don't dress up nice for a job that's gonna require you to clean toilets.
Yeah, like, just look presentable. That's all you gotta do.
You ain't got a
shoes that's not dirty, pants with no holes in it, and a shirt
that looks nice.
That's decent, like don't have the words F you on it.
Oh, of course not. You know jobs ain't gonna let you wear nothing that has like cuss words and stuff on it now.
It's been a minute since I've been here, so you may have to tell me. But I'll let you know.
Yeah.
But I feel like I done passed it.
What?
No, that's the next stop sign. Your stoplight.
You thought you passed? Oh, you thought you passed it already?
Yeah.
Nah, you good. I'm about to say one time in the morning I actually had passed it before.
Oh word?
Yeah. Like one time I was coming down here, I was like, bro, I passed it. I had it. Make a Yui.
But so
yeah, it is dark, bro. Like, crazy. But yeah, so and then you know when you're actually sitting down talking with the manager, you know what I'm saying?
Use your manners.
Yeah, use your manners, you know what I'm saying?
As my grandma says, take a table full of manners with you. So that way you won't forget them.
You know what I'm saying? Well, yeah,
take,
yeah, that
take them off the table and put them in your back pocket and pull one out as you need. Yes, sir, no, sir, yes, ma'am, no, ma'am.
Yeah, all that good stuff, man. You know what I'm saying? You gotta have those manners.
If the manager says a joke, laugh at it even if it's not funny.
Ooh.
Because that will make them feel more comfortable. Show them that you are a good, how do I say it, fellowship?
Good fellowship, yeah, there you go.
Yeah, that.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because that's the thing, like you want the manager, you know what I'm saying, to think,
feel comfortable with you and then be like, hey, you know,
like this
person right here ain't gonna be like coming in here one day and someone walk up to them and be like, hey, I hope you have a good day, and they be like, hey, screw you.
Yeah, stuff like that, you know what I'm saying? The manager wants to be able to, you know what I'm saying, work with you and know that you're gonna do a good job.
Now if you're trying to get into the military, then you know,
That's a whole different story, though.
Yeah, you want to be kind of an asshole.
Good morning to you. How can I help you?
Let's see. Do the sausage McMuffin with egg. Get two of those.
I need a sausage McMuffin with
egg.
Egg.
Say that again.
Two of those.
I need two sausage McMuffins.
Okay.
And a drink. Do a
what's a drink?
Do Sprite.
A large Sprite.
Uh-huh.
That'll do it.
All right, your total, 330 at the first one, please.
All right, thank you.
Oh, it's 330? Dang.
Well, yeah, then well, I forgot, because the thing is like a, oh, I said deal. 2 for $4, whatever they call it.
2 for $3.
It's same difference.
No, it's not.
You know what, bro?
That's a whole
Get out the car while I'm moving.
Huh?
Nothing.
Car watch movie.
I said get out the car watch. Hold this real quick. I said get out the car watch movie.
Alright, here, 330.
It's gonna take him a minute.
Okay.
No, it's not. Uh-huh. Shut up.
Here.
Wait,
here?
Yep. No, no, I'm not.
You have a great day. Thank you.
You too.
Please tell me, why does this dude have a regular black hat on with no logo? It doesn't say anything on that. It's just black. A regular black hat.
Like, do you have a logo on your person?
Huh?
On your skin?
No.
Then shut up.
You shut up. No, what you can go do, bro? You can go jump off
you
the
can
car. Watch your mouth. I don't appreciate that
you
language.
You can't watch your mouth.
Yes, I can.
I want to see you see your lips.
I can wash your mouth out with water and soap. That's what I mean by wash your mouth, bro.
I thought you said watch your mouth.
No, I didn't say watch your mouth. I said wash your mouth. One day I will do that, bro. One day I'm going to catch you slipping, and then that's what I'm going to do, bro. I'm going to clean the cuss words out your mouth. Freaking rated R.
There's a lot of movies that are good.
Hold this again. I gotta fix the zipper.
Well, do you have to zoom it in on me?
Bro, have confidence in yourself. That's your problem. See, guys, this is a thing, man. Especially
especially with going in for a job.
Talk about my confidence.
You don't have none.
Like, you know me.
I do know you. You don't have any.
You know me.
You barely have confidence. There you go. But no, make sure you have confidence in whatever you do. It doesn't matter.
Make sure I'm doing a little work.
What was that?
What?
It's my fault.
Yeah.
Yeah, shut up.
Shut up.
Shut up. But yeah, guys, for the interview, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, bring a table full of manners. You know what I'm saying? Always make eye contact, too.
Thank you. My bad.
Disrespectful. I almost said a cuss word, but I'm not. Because we have kids watching. I don't cuss on this channel.
Good for you.
You know what, DJ? One day, I hope a 18-wheeler knocks out your Trailblazer and you can't drive it no more. I hope you have to drive something crappy after that.
You know what I hope?
Don't even say it. I don't want to hear it.
I wouldn't hope for it, but this already came true.
What? Oh, bruh, stop playing. Why you have to do that on the D-Money? Yeah, guys.
You don't have to do me like that.
I'm just joking. Dang. But yeah, guys, for the interview, make eye contact, you know what I'm saying? Have manners, you know, and answer all the questions to the best of your ability, but still speak some truth. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, like if they ask you,
never lie.
Never lie, especially to the manager, bro. Oh, bro, you got to say with egg. They just gave me sausage and cheese on it, bro.
On a McMuffin?
Yes, it's sausage McMuffin with egg. It's all good though.
You say if you don't want it, I'll eat it.
I still eat it.
I'm hungry. You eat in front of me. That's her and more. I'm starving. But I want more eggs on that.
Why didn't you ask?
I just said I wasn't gonna ask you for nothing.
I wanna bite you some food.
No. I ain't gonna starve and die.
Yeah, but then if you don't eat nothing, you see someone else eat, that makes you hungry. You couldn't ask for us, bro.
I'm gonna have a really nice meal when I get home.
Oh, you sure?
Oh yeah. I'm gonna have me some grits with cheese. Thick slices of bologna, because you know we buy the bologna lard and we cut as thick as bologna. We fry it up, put it on that plate, cut it up real nice. Or in my case, a bowl that's already got grits in it. Chop it up real nice, put it in there, stir it up, fry me some eggs with the yolk, put them in to the grits bowl, stir that up real good, cut up the eggs. Get all the yolk in the eggs.
So you basically made like a breakfast bowl out of that?
Yeah.
Oh, that's lit.
I'm a fine breakfast eating and fixing machine. With two slices of buttered French bread.
Oh, well, guys, if you are hungry and you're looking for some food to eat, come to DJ's house. He'll fix something.
Bro, have we ever told them about Blaxican?
No.
Tell them about it.
All right.
Tell them the background of it, too.
Okay. Alright, guys, so back in high school, when me and DJ were,
We've been friends for about a year, and we had another class together.
Yeah, we had another class together,
and then one day, I
came to school wearing my jacket that said Mexico on it. Everyone that was Mexican was rocking with it, you know what I'm saying? And then when I got in the class with DJ, you know what I'm saying, I don't know who came with the idea, but... Okay. He came with the idea of Black. black and Mexican, then he call it Blackxican. And it's supposed to be like a a clothing store and like a food truck. And then we was like, yo, we actually should do that one day. And then we still probably could make it a thing, you know what I'm saying? Whenever we start hitting the milestones or whatever.
But hey, are you willing to give me a lighter?
Huh?
A lighter?
No.
Okay.
I'm just joking.
Really?
I was just playing.
Seriously.
How much is a lighter?
Like $1.
Okay.
40 something.
All right, you go get it.
I'm gonna have to have an ID, and I don't have that on me. Don't do that, kids. You gotta go in there and get that.
Oh my gosh. All right, that would be another dollar out of you, DJ.
I'll try to get it to you.
You better.
If I don't,
oh crap, I ain't got no mask.
You don't need a mask to go in here.
Okay. Dang, you ugly.
You aren't done without a gun, man. Give me the camera. Let me fix what you done.
Man, shut up. You freaking loser.
Okay, so he didn't explain it good enough.
Man, shut up.
So, would you quit? This is what really happened. He walked in the class one day during the winter wearing a Mexican that said Mexican on it. And it was a jacket. I was like... Me and him was joking around about it, and I came up with Blackxican. Well, I Googled it to see what it was, if it was even a real thing. Turned out it was a couple of food trucks and some kind of store. Well, I told Vincent, I was like, bro, we know how good Walmart is. I said, why not have like a Walmart mall type thing? He was like, what you mean? And I was like, you can go there, get, you know, your vehicle service, oil change, tires, you know, whatever. And instead of having to sit there and do nothing all day, starved out of your mind, and you don't want to go to some deli, there's Subways, McDonald's, Chick-fil-A, you know, whatever, like a mall. And you also got groceries, like a grocery section. You got a clothing section, just like Walmart, but glorified. That's what Blackxican is, in my opinion. This dude takes forever. It's a dadgum lighter, man. But yeah, that's what Blackxican is. To us. Vince has done a lot of stupid crap back in his day. Seriously, he really has. Actually, that's a lot. No, he ain't. He ain't done nothing bad. He too scared to. Boy, if he sees this, he gonna be mad when I say that. He too scared to do anything that's ever bad. But see, that's the thing. There's nothing wrong with being bad once in a while. Because sometimes being bad is the best way to get your point across. You know? Alright, he's coming back out here. I gotta talk like a good person.
Lord, that lady got a fat booty. There you go. Give me the camera. We're back, guys. So he told y'all the story about how Blackxican came up, and you know that's how it started up. But Hopefully we can put it to paper someday. You know what I'm saying?
What the heck?
What, bruh?
Thank you for the lighter.
You're welcome.
The first thing you say.
Because that's what I seen in the store, man. He has the, you know what I'm saying, I ain't gonna say the name, but that's what he got.
And you sticking around me.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I was just joking, guys. I just said that.
All right.
I just said that to be random, you know what I'm saying?
Gonna learn today.
But yeah, guys.
Gonna learn today.
That's another reason also why we, that's another reason why I'm trying to do YouTube, right? Be like, we're trying to be entrepreneurs as well. Like, you know what I'm saying? Have our own stuff.
Sure.
Yeah. But yeah, because, you know, black skin, and then, you know what I'm saying? We wanna.
By the way, I wanna talk to you about black skin.
Okay. What's up?
I've came up with a few foods.
See how we said food, right? See how I said food, right? I'm just joking.
That are really good.
Okay, what's up?
I was thinking about for the restaurant inside of Black Skin, because Black Skin is for the store.
It's going to be one big store with two different sections in it. One for food, one for clothes, yeah.
No. We talked about this. It's going to have a place where you can go to have your vehicle service, oil change, tire rotation, new tires, whatever.
What? I thought it was supposed to be like a clone store and then like food.
No, that's what we Googled it and that's what it came up to be.
Oh.
But I was talking about making it bigger. And you was like, bro, everybody don't like just going to get their tire rotated and oil change and all the other stuff and just sit there playing with the thumbs. They want to go get something to eat, get something to drink, go shopping. But I was thinking about the restaurant we're going to have it be called. Blues Mash. Is that a yay or a nay?
That's a no, sir. I'm sorry. No, I'm just kidding.
The dude opened up the door when I was pulling in here.
My fault. What time is it? I'm weird. But yeah. I guess you could do that because, you know what I'm saying? He loves blues, so. What the? That actually was a female, not a. You idiot. You stay assuming genders. That's a female. Where's that light I just bought you at? I need to burn you with it. I'm just joking. Shut up!
Dude, it won't even light. Look.
I was just joking right there. Don't. Man, shut up before I punt. Shut up!
What are you doing?
Using your charger.
Jesus, bud.
It's not my fault it's so freaking long. That was.
I wouldn't say that out loud no more.
Yeah. I'm definitely with you on that. But yeah, guys, that's another goal of ours. We want to be entrepreneurs as well. Like, you know what I'm saying? We want to be able to, you know, make our own stuff and, you know, stuff like that. So that's why we want to have that Blexican store thing. But, you know, if we can make that a real thing, that'll be pretty cool. You know what I'm saying?
I'm just sitting here with my truck running, acting like it's not drinking gas still.
And you know it's drinking gas. Oh, where I can put it right there now.
Congratulations to you.
Shut up. That's why I pay for your gas.
Because I'm taking you back and forth from work to work. Or to work from work.
I'm just playing. Dang.
Damn.
Shut up! That's gonna be a great merch line, bro. Just wait till you make that merch. I'm gonna make sure it looks good, bro. It says "Shut up." It's gonna be lit. But yeah, we're doing YouTube because we want to be entrepreneurs. You know what I'm saying? For real, like, you know, when I for example, you know what I'm saying, I'm pretty sure all y'all know Emily Choppa, you know what I'm saying? And some other rappers in the rap game. And what they're doing is they're not signing to labels and stuff like that because, you know, when you sign to a label, you got a contract that you have to go through. And, you know what I'm saying, whenever you make, they get a good portion of them and stuff like that. But, you know what I'm saying, he wanted to be independent and, you know what I'm saying, he is... And he's still doing that, you know what I'm saying? And he's doing real successful in the rap game right now. And he made a whole bunch of money without, you know what I'm saying, without a label. So, you know, that kind of motivated me and got me thinking, like, hey, if he can become...
How rich is Soulja Boy?
You see this, right? I'm talking about entrepreneurship. And he's over here talking about how much money does Soulja Boy make. You think I know?
I didn't say how much he make. I said how much does he have.
You think I know that? No. Go look it up. Shut up.
First of all, you take the bass out your voice when you talk to me. Second of all, you don't holler at me when I'm right here. This ain't the military, homeboy. I will smack the F out of you.
Yeah, sure you would. Yo, chill. I'm just joking, bro, but why are you going to ask that question? I'm talking about entrepreneurship. I'm talking about...
Because I remember back when I was at IJA in 2019.
You should have looked it up for yourself to find out, dog. I don't know how much he has.
But he had just gotten signed, and I remember Soulja Boy when I was growing up. I thought he'd been signed by somebody. And it was like, he finally got signed for the first time.
Oh. Shut up, bro. I was talking about entrepreneurship, man. You over here trying to... You being like me, man. But nah, I thought about that. I ain't
nothing like you.
No, what you just did was something that I would have done while you were talking. Interrupted you. That's why I meant you, dummy. See, this is what happens when you meet someone like this, bro. This guy's a pain in my butt 24/7. I don't know what
up. This pain in the butt is the one taking me back and forth.
But I still love this man.
But where's that big ass forehead?
I was just joking. Hey, Mia, you better hide your baby oil.
You better hide that big ass forehead.
I was just joking. But yeah.
Did you know that scene, The Rock actually forgot what he was supposed to have said and just improvised?
Wait, seriously?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's crazy.
But it was when he said that, that was like, that's actually better than what we had, so. That's why Ludacris was like,
yeah, I'm about to say, I seen that part, though. That's funny, though.
Because it was unexpected. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to hold it, make sure it doesn't fall.
I would.
But yeah, guys, this is actually going to end off the video right here, man. I got to go into work, as usual, you know what I'm saying, 6:45,
2:45. Like, comment, share, subscribe.
With your family, your cats and dogs, your friends, all that good stuff, you know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all hit that red button.
You really just say your cats and dogs?
Yes!
Well, don't forget about the squirrels, the lizards, the hamsters.
You know what I'm saying? That's the purpose of it.
What's the difference between a hamster and a guinea pig?
I think a guinea pig is like a science experiment. Mm-hmm. I think a guinea pig is a science experiment. But yeah, guys, this is going to have the video, man. Make sure, you know what I'm saying, y'all click that big red button before y'all leave the channel. It's that subscribe button. Make sure y'all hit that before y'all leave, man. And, you know what I'm saying? Let me see what else. Oh, yeah. Make sure you hit the bell on our channel. Make sure you don't miss any notifications from us when we post the video. You know what I'm saying?
I forgot about that.
I completely forgot about that. I just thought about that today. But yeah, make sure y'all hit that bell. So y'all don't miss anything from us, you know what I'm saying? Because we drop videos daily, every day, you know what I'm saying? We always post them because this Stack Squad, we on the way and we coming up. So like, share, comment, subscribe. We love y'all so much. Thank y'all for watching. And we'll see y'all in the next video, man. Peace.